welcome back to Reading Homestuck. We got Arthur and Mason today. Hope you liked the Troll Sona video. Thursday just gone.
Oh god.
It was certainly something to record. It was an event.
Yeah, it was an event. It was one of the events of all time.
It was, in fact, an event. Alright, let's just get right into it.
Let's get right into the news.
No, it has to be five times as long.
Let's get right.
This is making it bigger. Da 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 da. Keemstar goes Super Saiyan.
Going Super Saiyan 3 over there. Okay, right, we're back. We're in ship.
Oh.
Bridge. Well, that's where Gamzee's been. Okay, that explains that. Oh,
we found Carl.
He's wearing a ring. Oh, that's where the ring went.
Oh, yes. The one ring.
Huh. Well, that was less expected than the alternative. Arthur, you know what to do.
Oh, hello, my bard. Rise, my bard. I mean... What? Hello! Hello, my bard! Sheesh!
She's making fun of herself.
Alrighty, if you want people to stop taking you seriously, your Shinra party is gonna need some work.
Oh, I do that.
I do that.
Give me the ring! No, it's mine!
When you've got the sun in your eye.
And she's alive again.
Oh.
Now, loyal minstrel, wake! Wake, I say!
What?
Give me the ring! Give it to me!
Hang on, where's the fucking... Where is it?
Yeah, here we go.
Arthur?
Oh!
Oh god. I thought I just had a piano key.
Anyway, we got.
My god, there's a murderer on the loose.
You're on my watch.
Anyway.
Oh, just great. Now, what does she want this time? Shallow.
Hey, Twerkit! The fuck do you think you're doing?
I have no idea what you're talking about. I have never twerked it in my life.
Ugh.
Yeah, you can, flat ass. Anyway, bullshit!
Oof.
You went after the blue nerd's ring.
Sorry.
You're wearing it now, ain't you?
I couldn't say, Mina. I do like to wear jewelry from time to time, just like you. I mean, it's certainly possible there is a shiny new ring on my finger, but... So what if there is?
I liked it, so I put a ring on it.
Arania, so help me God, you need to take that shit off right now! Throw it in a volcano or something, just come home!
I'm surprised you didn't say like that shit, also something reference.
First, I would appreciate it if you referred to me as... Mind Fang. Remember how I've been trying to make them a thing lately? Secondly, I have no intention of discarding this ring now or ever. Wheels are already in motion, Mina. Irons are heating up as we speak.
Wheels? Irons? Arania, what? Mind Fang, what are you even planning? You gonna meddle? You gonna meddle? I just know it. Ugh.
Oh, I mean, sorry, my nose is very blocked for some reason, but it's very fitting for this character.
The ring has blocked my nose.
The congestion, that's the downside of coming back to life. You immediately become congested.
Becoming mortal again is a very painful process.
Oh god, I don't remember my bones rubbing together as much. I'm just taking some initiative for a change. Has it occurred to you that it may have become a little tiresome for me to spend an eternity as a boring nobody while so many others got the very important roles in determining the fate of reality? Heck, you were barely dead for 2 minutes before you started assembling an army. Even my alternate universe self got to lead an amazing life, which is all well and good for her. But what about me, Mina? Water... about me.
Yo, I feel you on that. Trust me, girl, but you do realize you're making a glubbing mess here. I mean, you know this shit ain't, like, part of the legit chain of events. You aren't supposed to be there.
Of course I know that. Like I said, I have a plan.
What plan?
I am going to take over this session and make sure it never bears fruit. If I can stop this universe from being created, then the young Lord of Time will have never hatched. In the first place, I won't merely be defeating an invincible foe, I will be erasing all the pain he has ever caused.
Sir, have you lost it? You know all you're doing is making another doomed timeline where everyone dies, right?
Oh, of course I know that. Please, Mina, don't insult me. I've given this a lot of thought. If anyone else attempted this, what you said would be true. But I am not just anyone. I am a very powerful sylph of light. I have millions of sweeps to have honed my abilities. And as one gifted with the aspect of light, certain outcomes will be prone to working in my favour. And as an ancient, highly experienced sylph, I wield an unprecedented ability to heal. A doomed timeline is really just an anatomical feature of a much larger organism, like a capillary which comes to an end because it has withered and died. I believe I will be able to heal this offshoot, and with enough time and patience, I am confident I can restore its vitality to such a great extent it will effectively take over as the Alpha Timeline, thus reducing English to a lost footnote in Paradox Space. Then, the new Alpha Timeline will flourish under my immortal care. I will watch over it for eternity, assuring peace and harmony everywhere, and there will be a new progeny of universes, and those universes will beget more universes, and each will benefit from my good grace. I will personally make sure nothing like the English mishap ever occurs again. I mean, this is mostly theoretical, of course, but now the most important thing here is that I am involved. It is all vital to our interests that I at least try.
The English mishap is when Americans don't understand when to put a U after an O in a word.
The English mishap was the Empire. Yeah.
No, the English mishap was everything past the Saxons.
Yeah.
No, they fucked up too. The English mishap was everything past the Gaels.
Yeah.
No, the English mishap was everything past the Mudfish.
The English mishap was the formation of the landmass in the first place.
They're really fucked up with that one.
Yeah. Anyway.
Can't spell English without L.
True.
For real.
Aight. So you just totally flipped your think pan is all. Got it.
Oh, I appreciate the vote of confidence. Are we done here?
No. So your timeline healing fantasy aside, your plan is to just waltz in there and knock over the whole session? You do realize that means you'll have to take down my grown-up self. Like, not to blow my own conch, but she is arguably the greatest, deadliest, most styling badass who ever lived.
I'm aware, but there is no one who is in a better position to deal with her than myself. After all, who knows you better than I?
Okay, yeah, but you ain't exactly shopping for a mind fang. You got all these sick powers, yo.
Oh, well, it's like I said. I've had quite a long time to refine my abilities. I will have a few tricks up my sleeve.
Bro, prep time.
Man, this is gonna go terribly.
Batman with prep time. Ooh.
I'm 4 parallel universes ahead of you.
Arania, I regret to inform you that you are currently going up against fucking Gojo and Saitama as one guy.
Batman with prep time, that's on us.
You're like Damian Wayne minute. At 2 years
15
old.
15 minutes prep time. Batman wins. 9 years, he waits for them to die of old age. He has healthier diet. 9 years prep
Batman,
time.
Batman builds up speed for 12 hours. Batman
I like
wins.
The implication that the fusion of, this hypothetical fusion of Gojo and Saitama dies 9 years from the moment this confrontation is suggested.
Yeah.
Of natural causes.
Bad health. Not malnutrized. Gojo just eats sweets and Saitama is poor. So
what you're saying is that this the ultimate killer here is going to be the worldwide healthcare system.
It's scurvy. He dies of scurvy.
Yeah, no,
the motherfucker just doesn't eat oranges ever.
Indirectly, it's Batman's fault because, I mean, Bruce Wayne has all that money. He could donate it to the world.
Yeah, he could
make a fund to help the people with
scurvy. He could use it spending his bank credit card.
He's choosing not to.
Anyway, we were at Mina, I must say.
Well, Mina, I must say your attitude is a little surprising. I'm typically one. Typically gung-ho about such audacious escapades.
Yeah, well, there's audacious and then there's bald-faced flipping insanity.
Ugh.
That was a stretch. Anyway, besides...
That was a very stretch.
Did you ever stop and think about me?
No.
You been alive again? I'm just running with that as the line.
Yep.
Anyway, you been alive again? All running around and stirring up trouble while I'm still a ghost. I'm gonna miss you.
I miss you too, Mina.
I miss my wife, Mina. I miss her a lot. I'll be back.
I am your wife! Anyway, will I ever see you again?
I don't really know. When you're trying to do the right thing, there's always a sacrifice involved, remember? We all died in the first place.
I guess.
Besides, I'm sure Riska would approve of my plan. Maybe she can explain my reasoning better than I have.
No. Actually, Circuit Deuce isn't down with this at all.
What? She isn't?
Nope. She thinks you're being dumb as a fuck.
I like that.
Oh, what does she say exactly? What? Are those her exact words?
Dunno. It's in the Circuit Twins' message to real... To really...
It's real life, but eel.
I thought it was really. I thought it was...
Yeah, no.
Really. But no.
It's in the Circuit Twin message relay service.
Oh, is she there with you?
Yeah.
Can you put her on?
No.
Can I just talk to her already?
No.
Let me talk to the people.
I just want to say a couple of things. Call her yourself.
I don't have a phone.
I need to hear this.
No, bitch, don't touch my clan.
30.
21 posed as a question.
I was going to say circuit posed as a
call
question.
Back, anyway.
Very well. You have both made yourselves abundantly clear. I will go it alone. What? I will go it alone. But that's what I was signing up for in the first place, I suppose. Goodbye, Mina. Take care.
Got to leave Mina. You all behind and face the truth.
Mina. She couldn't be much meaner. Now then, what to do about you? Shall I continue to manipulate you, or will you comply with my orders if I decide to loosen my grip? Perhaps the threat of being controlled again will be enough to keep your capricious tendencies in check. I guess it's a risk. You seem so serene and compliant. Alright, I will be gracious and allow you some free will privileges. Use them wisely, my trusty jungler.
Motherfuck, who's all this fresh pimp rider? I got my wicked peep on for suddenly. It's a motherfucking ninja-licious whole titty miracle jacked up in this bitch-ass motherfuck.
You have to say bitch-ass motherfucker and lose your job.
No, never mind. Wow. You'll not be speaking again. No. Never again, actually. Wow. I thought Makara was awful. He's the other decency to show his mouth shut. Now. Anyway, I've wasted enough time dithering around with fools. There is much work to be done.
Ooh.
Yep.
Ooh.
This mind control, I'm gonna be real. Mind control seems a little morally wrong.
Yeah.
It's almost like she's like obviously doing some villain shit.
Mind control seems. Is this Carcat really?
Yeah, we're coming back. We're coming over to Carcat.
Roasting flies on a stick.
Look, man, he's like, he's not god tier. He doesn't even have rainbow drinker powers.
Oh, yeah.
He's
bro, even
functionally
bro,
useless.
He's got no money, no bitches, no swirl, and no drip.
He's the of this show.
Carcat right now is just sat around because literally everybody else has powers. And
looking
he's
level
just
one
out
Carcat
here like, I have a cool sickle. I could stab somebody once, maybe, and then they'd probably just come back to life immediately anyway, because almost everyone I know is god tier.
My dad versus my mom.
Like, all the bad guys are good, are god tier.
it's like losing to Glass Joe and Punch Out.
Yeah, no, you have to let him have that one.
It's like he gets one permakill.
You like, get one free like permakill.
He is just like Glass Joe for real.
So pathetic.
Yeah, that's how they kill English. He's like, oh god, all right, you can have one.
It's like in literally any Mega Man game, the final boss is weak to like the most useless weapon in the game.
Yeah. Anyway, right.
Friggin' strike chain.
Nubs McShouty! Come in, Shouty! Do you read me?
What? Right, wrong voice. Get out.
Aradia! Get out of the chat!
What? Who's there?
Oh, it's speaker crap.
Shouty, is that you?
Shouty, like a melody.
I was just about to say.
That I can't forget. Na 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 na, every day. I want to go fucking. My pizza's cold, so I need to give it a quick microwave and. I can't while I'm speaking.
Oh, okay.
No, it's fine. I'll just...
Big man, shout! Stop singing!
I mean, no, this is Carcat. Is this Mina?
Yeah!
Oh, hey, long time no... I didn't think I'd hear from you again. I'm telling you to piss off or anything. I'm just surprised. How have you been? I mean, never mind. That's a fucking stupid question. You're a ghost. Still a ghost, right? Hey, look, I know we made those tentative plans where I was going to join your army, and then I guess I'm really coming out because, I don't know, I guess some shit came up. I don't know how things go. Anyway, I'm sorry I never saw you after that or called you, or, you know, I didn't even know it was a fucking option to call you. Maybe someone could have told me that was an actual fucking possibility. You know, what a crazy thought. Useful, practical information being imparted to me in some manner of once in my fucking...
Shouty, shut the fuck up.
A melody in my head.
We got a whale of a problem here.
Okay. Ship. The ship is parked.
Captain Falcon is parallel parking.
Okay, right. Who wants to do Jane's voice? Is there?
What is Jane's voice?
It's a sort of corporate, like a telemarketer kind of voice, I guess. Like an automated phone call type voice.
Oh,
I'm calling today to ask you about your extended warranty.
Precisely that. Go.
Granted to Harley. Come in, Harley. Do you read me?
Yes.
I suggest that you come to Durs right away.
What is it?
We potentially have a problem here that is rather significant in size.
I just decided to do this.
That's fine.
You go from there.
It's against my programming to impersonate a deity. Oh, Neytiri. I'm learning so much about myself through your primitive culture, Snore.
Oh boy. I think this is
class.
I think the Neytiri is probably Arania, comedy purposes. Also, she's the only person who could be here with that color text, so. Arthur?
Well, as we know from a certain friendly fast bear, the color of text is very important.
Jake is
done, British. Jake.
Oh, good heavens.
I know, I'm Jake.
No.
Oh, wow, it's me.
You're doing Arania's voice again. For this nature.
It's me, the devil.
steal candy from babies and small businesses.
Hey, Jake, it's me, the devil.
Mason.
What's that, Neytiri? Snooze. Why, yes. Of course Of course I'm open to exploring alien intercourse with you.
Oh, what is this human thing you call kissing? Oh, let us retire to your chambers, Captain.
God.
Jake!
Do what with my tail now? Oh my.
Jake, wake up!
Hold your horses, Neytiri. I'm doing my best here. You know mobility isn't my strong suit, what with this wobbly pair of puppet legs God gave me? Slumber.
Jake, shut the fuck up!
What?
Greetings, Jake. We meet again.
Arania?
Wait. Oh my god. I feel like Greetings, Jake. We meet again. But no, we've already stopped the voice.
No. Swap Jake. It. Who cares?
Greetings,
swap
Jake.
It.
We meet again.
Arania? Wait, this means I'm still dreaming, doesn't it?
No. On the contrary. You are
no,
a
No, I just replaced.
We meet again, Buzz Lightyear, for the last time. Not today, Zerg.
Yeah, just replace it with... No.
Hold the phone. You're not a spooky ghost, babe, anymore. Girl, ghost girl, dang it.
No, Jake, I have returned from the dead for good, and I have come for you.
Gulp? Surprise Pikachu.
Surely you remember the first time we met and what we talked about.
Yeah, mostly.
Well, it doesn't matter, the plan has changed.
No, wait,
once spoke of your destiny. The one whereby you will deal with the Lord of Time, his first defeat. Do you recall?
No. I mean, maybe?
Cool. It doesn't matter, the plan has changed.
It has?
Yes. How does that make you feel?
I was about to say!
In every
okay,
hero,
yes!
Battle, there dwells a great...
yeah. No. We're actually reading the line.
Yes, Jake. You see, in every hero of hope, there dwells a great hidden power unravelled by that of any other aspect. And for a page, the journey to reach his full potential is longer than it is for any other class. But once that journey is over, how fearsome he becomes.
I have reached my full potential.
And I am here to shorten that journey for you. And in return for this fable, you will serve my needs.
How?
We will partake in the human thing known as kissing.
God,
my man
is
retire to our chambers.
Pod,
my man is
I don't
definitely
want to say
going
Jake
through
because...
some. He's going through some PTSD flashbacks of whatever just of what just happened between him and fucking Jane, like an hour ago tops. This face is definitely not going to bring good things to
I am now sans Undertale. Look into my eye.
The god of everything. There are many obstacles within that are preventing you from accessing your true potential. You cannot see them, Jake, but I can, with my sans eye. I can see every fault and fissure in your mind. You have an Oedipus complex.
Oh.
That is very strange. Please grow as an individual. My
vision
Please
grow
and
change as an individual.
Sheds light on every injury you have ever suffered, whether emotional or physical. Why is only attracted to ghosts? I can repair it all for you, Jake.
Oh, no.
Using my mighty power, I can heal your mind.
Oh, no.
We must only partake
in the human rights of kissing. Now, that thing, hand it over to me, your dark soul. What's the matter?
Stop, please stop. Why does everyone want to kiss me all the time? What did I ever do to deserve this sort of attention? I don't know what you all see in me. I just don't understand it. Don't you see? I just want you to leave me alone. Cheese and stupid crackers, I'm a man, not a piece of meat.
Wow. All right. Jesus Christ. Sorry, I just assumed since you were thirsting after me in your dream or whatever. I'm sorry,
no,
there. See,
it was all a lie. I only like to kiss
your
boys.
Personal boundaries. We don't have to kiss, good grief. That went poorly. I only tried to kiss you because I knew you were attracted to me. I thought I was doing you a favour. I don't know what I'm supposed... Well, sigh. You really are a piece of work, Jake. Here I am, a literal mind reader, and I still can't figure you out. But you're right. My advances were inappropriate, and in the future, I will attempt to be more respectful.
Well, if only all men were like that.
Yeah.
I'm still going to heal your mind, though. No! It's nothing personal, kid. Get
no
souped.
Shit.
Your power is too important to my scheme. I'm a very important individual and I love schemes.
Who took my ship?
I don't know.
When I arrived, it was already parked here. Most illegally, I might add.
That is so
Shut
illegal.
Up, Doc.
Shut... You're not in this scene. Anyway, maybe we should call in some authority regulators to have it ticketed and towed.
If you really wanted to relocate the vehicle, couldn't you just, you know, teleport it somewhere else?
We should take the vehicle and push it somewhere else!
Yes.
Nice illegal idea, criminal.
But I love watching those guys write their little tickets. They're so cute.
And Jade would enjoy Zootopia then, for multiple reasons.
She is a furry, so...
Indeed. So, but yeah. Observing adorable creatures issue citations will not address our problem.
You think we should ask the Condes what to do?
I would rather not involve her in this matter. We should be more than sufficiently equipped to handle it.
Yes, you're right. What would she think if we went whimpering to her every time some buffoon parked a battleship illegally?
She would think we were a couple of silly children.
Yeah.
What?
Maybe we should check on the prisoners again.
That would be a logical course of action.
Whoa.
What?
Something's happening.
Something is always happening.
Yes, but something large in specific. Fucking... Okay, yeah, no, just... Ultimate power just fucking erupts, holy shit.
Oh god. Da 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 da.
Okay, Mason, please.
Sorry, it's just so appropriate.
There's already gonna be definitely gonna be fucking musical accompaniment to this.
Oh yeah.
Okay, Arthur. Got a Roxy line here. We got a Roxy line.
Roxanne, sorry.
Did you think
Rose.
You were being called on for the musical accompaniment?
No,
because
well, no,
Alex just didn't want me to do it.
Arthur, the brass section!
I was trying to remember what Rose.
Arthur on brass, Mason on percussion.
Wrong Lalonde. Wrong Lalonde.
Right, yeah. Shazam.
The one who was a drunkard first.
Ah. Yeah, I think I'm gonna stay invisible for a while.
Oh god.
I'm being filled with
Sally Ho!
Okay, what was that, Mason?
what it says on the screen. Tally-ho! Tally-ho!
Yeah, cut out a bit.
God damn it.
The first time, anyway.
Like my god!
Arthur, do you want to take Dave's sprite?
Why? Oh, wait, no, it's
solid snake.
It's one.
More power! It's
all work! What?
Don't say it! Oh, god.
Exceeding a certain amount in qualities and quantities!
Jay, cease powering up at once. You're destroying the Empire property.
Oh, sorry, Jay. God damn it.
God damn it. Anyway. Arthur?
I'm Jay.
Oh, I'm making him. The voice has changed this, I remember. I remember now. Yes, this is the new voice. And you new yellow man. Kind of voice. I don't think he can hear you right now. The hope field is now impenetrable. Shut up. Your
who
mother.
You.
You, me, I'm nobody. You wouldn't know me. You wouldn't know me.
Harley, you deal with Jake. I will subdue the smart troll.
Okay.
You wouldn't know me. You wouldn't.
It's just as the ancient stone tablets predicted.
Stern fatherly confusion. Sorry, Jake. You heard the lady. You're making a royal mess of the place, so I'm gonna have to zap you to the furthest rim. What I'm saying is, you've been very naughty and rambunctious, and now you have to go outside.
Gadzooks!
What? Why can't I zap you away?
Boy, howdy!
Shut up! You're booming of cooling ball exclamations are hurting my dog ears! Come on, Jade. Focus, Dan!
She's trying to do the Yoshikage kick. Oh, God!
Yeah! So hard to concentrate, you have to stare at his stupid looking joints. I never wanted to see my grandpa in a sexy pair of underpants.
Why is that holy sexy?
Toledo!
Stop calling them sexy. Yes, please.
Anyway.
What's the holdup?
My powers. Can't seem to penetrate the Hulk field.
Land sakes alive!
Also, he keeps doing that!
So I have overheard. Jake, your righteous ascension has been quite impressive, but that is incredibly annoying.
Hello, nurse!
Oh, for Pete's sake.
That is a sign.
So is for Pete's sake.
Certainly is one.
Yeah, that's one. We'll let him have that.
Anyway, Arthur. We'll let him have that one.
We're going to subdue me. I'm waiting for this crocker.
What game are you playing, troll? Stake your designs on my future husband.
Got so absolutely
thrown off balance by the future husband remark that she reverted to the previous one.
That's good.
I like it. She thinks it sounds cool. It doesn't, but she's trying her hardest. Bless her.
Once he has finished equalizing, I'll tear your empire apart.
You will do no such thing.
Alright. Then it would seem the next move is yours. I trust your weapon is not just for show. Or did her goddess see fit to equip her heiress with a training fork?
Dot. My calculations say that this is highly probable. You are enticing me into a trap.
Oh, it's no trap. I assure you, I simply cannot be killed. You'll see, as long as a certain charm remains in my possession, I am immortal. Or even more immortal than usual.
I cannot be vanquished. More immortal than usual.
Yes.
Don't. That's stupid.
By gum!
Good gravy. Can't you shut him up?
Sadly, no. Sorry.
You win. If I can't bat you out, then I have no choice but to let you trash in your lady's crop.
If I can't blast you away, I'll just have to pound you into oblivion.
Whereas you, let's face it, I'm not.
I've never seen that before.
Nor I. Oh shit, Arthur's dying.
The plan is to send you on a very emotionally fulfilling journey, and then
there we go.
Speak okay, of the devil.
Arthur, car cat.
Do you fucking read me?
Go. No, I'll take it.
We have a problem here.
What? What was that?
Are you that little ass again?
Dude, your words are all muffled. Can you speak up?
I said we are...
Louder.
Louder,
man. Sound doesn't travel through foam too well.
I said we may have a really big fucking problem over here.
I'm on my way.
Oh. Bob's your uncle.
And...
Oh my god. Stop powering up already. Just do the line.
Don't listen to her, Jake. Continue powering up for as long as you would prefer. You're doing wonderfully. I mean, don't listen to her, Jake. Never mind. Ask it. Fuck it.
You call that powering up? Hey. I asked you a question. You call that powering up?
Jumping Jehoshaphat!
I'll show you the true meaning of powering up. Frankly, you're hopeful, ridiculous, and has nothing on the unlimited fury of the green sun.
The full concentrated power.
Back on some! Won't you come?
Man, you're pretty strong.
Wait a minute.
See ya!
Why did I decide to swap spirits with my planet? What was I even thinking?
Uh-oh. Suck it to me!
Impossible!
Krakatoa.
How can the power of hope be so...
Shiver me timbers!
Powerful!
Average British
person. No!
White privilege.
Oh god. No! How can this be happening to me? Don't you realize who you're dealing with? I am Grimbar, damn it.
Win.
I am the most powerful doggy girl.
One.
Who has ever existed.
Four.
In the history of Paradox Space.
The Gipper!
skip it across the lava.
That's a little funny.
Oh, it's like a Kung Fu Panda villain. KO!
Well, KO, yeah. This is usually the game.
And she was white.
Game!
She's fully powered down now, so she's no longer, you know, Grimbar, so that's okay.
I'm not wanting to do this like somebody who wasn't
ready. Imagine.
Do you even realize what you have just done to our biological daughter? You are out of control. Come to your senses this instant.
I know that you have a great deal of fondness for your human family member, even though you have been corrupted by an evil creature. As such, it sincerely pains me to have to do this. But the moment she wakes up, she will simply become possessed again. And then, where would we be?
Wait. Do what?
I'm going to kill your daughter.
What?
I'm not sorry. I'm going to enjoy this. This is actually my only joy in life. I mean, I haven't been alive very long, so... I'll admit, not a high bar. Anyway, I'm going to drown your daughter.
I'm about to drown your ass.
It's a reverse 9/11.
Oh god, I was going to say something to that tune,
instead
but I decided not to.
The tower, I'm going
to
kill people with the tower falling on them.
President, there's been a second tower. Oh shit!
Now steal a shoes.
Wizard of Oz.
That's what I was about to say.
This is what the reference.
The reference.
Oh no! It's been so long. Hell yeah! It's been so long since I last have seen a shot last to this monster.
That was a really good spot to do with that joke. I am very pleased they made the Wizard of Oz joke. I was thinking the exact same thing I was like.
Surely, Brown, this is what the reference. Lift off. Whirly bird.
Oh yeah, bitches, become a baby.
Yeah, that's the fucking. That's the fucking ad.
Oh, that made me smile.
Oh, we're back with the
back of the fucking building again.
The please stop.
Clock.
Ouch.
God tier death clock.
Oh, was that a heroic death?
Just death. It's literally, it's on screen, man. Like, you're looking.
It's just
it.
Death.
It says just.
So that was a just death. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know the rules
so she's
for this.
Like,
I've never seen this shit before.
It literally says just on the screen. But
yeah,
also,
but I was
okay.
Looking at the thing going back and forth, and you guys have only ever said heroic.
Mm. I mean...
Lucky break.
Anyway, but lucky break. So, from the quick flash of Rani's eye, it seems like external forces can, like, influence the clock.
Mm.
Not, like, force a result necessarily, but, like, influence it to be harsher or more lenient, potentially.
So, yeah, it was luckier.
Considering the fact that Jade herself didn't actually directly do anything evil. Really, but she was influenced by evil, and verbally enforced evil, but didn't actually act towards evil to do anything outwardly evil. Really,
so she dies now because that was a death that counted.
Yeah,
she got put down.
She's dead. Dead.
Deserved.
Damn it, bro. Womp womp. Anyway, all right, Mare. I've got to go now. Not sure why, but I have a really bad feeling about all of this. I mean, I don't want to scare you or come off as too dramatic or anything, but if I never see you again, I just wanted you to know. Been real, man. You were always there for me. Shared my darkest hours, my deepest secrets. And I'll never fucking forget. Goodbye, man.
Do you think love can bloom on a battlefield?
Rose, come in, Rose. Do you read me? Over. Rose was, we've got to have...
Oh, I'll do that. Yes?
You might want to get your ass in gear. Shit's going down on Lofath.
Could you elaborate?
There's problems.
Then let us bounce.
Well, like this plush ass cheek.
That's all.
Baseball.
You've got some nerve. I will return shortly to annihilate you. Stay put.
Take your time. I'm not going anywhere.
I love the excessive winks.
got just one. Roxy!
I like that she's just stopped doing the quote-unquote cool voice.
Well, there's no one around here that she needs to impress.
Well, I mean, there is, actually. Oh, is the thing. Oh, fuck.
Addo, you're there. Hello, it's me.
Frick.
Mumble, mumble, hag, mumble, suck it, grumble. Mutter, mutter, my egregious patootie. Dot, dot.
And it's Gamzee coming in with a steel chair!
And here comes a giant fist! Block this overhead.
Okay.
You might as well come out of hiding so I can see you. Don't you look nice? I always do quite like the rogue outfit. Anyway, needless to say, I'm quite partial to the Void Killer scheme.
Okay, who the fuck's doing?
I can do Roxy if you want.
Okay, Mason, go.
I'm so fucking flattered. Who are you?
I beg your pardon?
You heard me, bitch.
Okay. Who are you? Yes, I remember now. Who am I, you ask? That's no short story, I'm afraid. It all began on a peaceful, idyllic planet called Before Us. Unlike the Alternian trolls, with whom you are no doubt more than familiar, my people were.
Wowee, shut your dumb blue mouth. I've been spying on you and eavesdropping on all your smug trash, and I couldn't help but notice that ring you're wearing.
Yes, what about it?
That's Jong's ring. Jong? That's John's ring, ain't it?
Well, I mean, technically, John never rightfully owned it, so, in fact, it was originally intended as a gift to my young descendant, and it's only fitting that I wear it and bring it into additional glory to the circuit name and all that, so,
yeah, that's,
you know,
another.
Legally, I'm covered, actually, so go on, call the police, call the cops, go on, you knock.
I don't think there are any police.
Yeah,
that's another insane and smug thing you just said just there. Do you even listen to yourself? For real though, we were gonna give that ring to Kelly.
Why would I listen to myself? I can already hear what I'm saying.
That's Kelly, my goddamn BFFC from space. She's a ghost and I want to save her from her bro.
Yes, the female cherub. I am perfectly familiar with her plight. As well as the revelance she purportedly has with respect to her brother's downfall. In fact, I was the first one ever to theorize about that.
Some mug.
Ah, but the situation has changed. That is all ancient history now. Kind of, that's all ancient history now. Probably wouldn't like that. Never mind, I'll stop.
You mean you were just going to stop the line, or what?
You were going to make a reference to something.
Did you just make a joke that flopped so hard you forgot where you were?
Yeah, but also, it was...
Oh,
was
that's
just
sad.
Referencing something.
Oh, that's sad. That's anyway, boom. You're there.
I'm sorry, Roxy, but I have no use for your cherub friend in my plan. She will not be playing a role of significance.
Oh, man, I way hate you.
Oh, come on now, don't say things like... You can't take back. I mean, I was actually very nice. You're just getting off on the wrong foot here.
No. Oh, man, I really hate you. I can't even explain it. I never hated somebody so much by just a few smarmy words out of their grody chew hole. Ugh, yuck, ick, blarf. So, yeah, now that I buttered you up and all, give me that ring.
No.
What if I say pretty please?
Quite the black solicitation, though. Unfortunately, I don't think I will be able to. No, not as a racial.
Wow, that's not a good look.
No, that's not what I meant. That's not what I. Shut up.
You know, troll.
Unfortunately,
heard the monologue.
I could give you another monologue if you prefer. Anyway. Unfortunately, I don't think I will be able to reciprocate your feelings of hostility. I've had you to be too charming.
still, you do have a way with words. If I were compatible in that quadrant, you might have swept me off my feet.
What?
Besides, I don't have time for new relationships right now. Too many irons in the fire, as you can see. It's get to be a little bothersome having people fling themselves at you all the time. It's always been my curse. Did you know earlier today your friend Jake could barely keep his hands off me?
What? No way, you're a filthy liar.
Relax, I've been known to embellish from now and then. I'm just having some fun with you. But now the fun times are over. I gotta have an invisible, intangible troublemaker tiptoeing around to sneak this ring off my finger, so I'm afraid I will have to put you down.
Yeah, right, I'm gonna let you put me down on my dead body.
No, I mean,
you would also be dead in that scenario.
That is actually the plan, but don't be so dramatic. Your body will only be napping. This is my one joy. Killing you.
Sleep.
Pleasant dreams forever.
I'm Emir.
I just gave you an aneurysm. You are now comatose forever.
Puff. This is it then, isn't it? Am I to spend the rest of eternity hiding inside this vortex? How can I go in search of myself if I am blown to smithereens the moment I set foot outside? Maybe the truth is, such a fate would be preferable to this. I'm so dreadfully lonely.
Don't kill yourself, there's so much to live for. Please.
Have they all forgotten about me? I guess I couldn't blame them for getting on with their lives. After all, what use am I? The only remotely important thing there is for me to do is to go looking for a more important version of myself. And I can't even bloody well do that much. I was a fool to expect anything more from my life. My kind was never meant to have friends. Still, I wish I had not been so hasty in tossing Roxy and her sunny mum from my hideout. Even if they would have attracted attention. So what? Just a little longer. A little longer would have been nice. What's this now? That doesn't look like one of my memories. Is someone here? Hello? Who's there? What's happening? Oh dear, this can't be good. I'd better hide. God, shoot, are those footsteps? Oh shoot, gotta hide. Whoever is there, don't come any closer. Please don't. I'm so scared and so miserable and so lonely. I said, don't come any closer. I'm a powerful magician. I swear, what a time for a typo. a magician who wants you to leave her alone. Pay no attention to the girl behind the curtain.
Someone's in here. Hi.
Hi. It's okay, I won't hurt you. I'm a friend.
Also, when you double die, you go there.
Well, I mean, when you die, you enter fucking dream bubble place wherever, and Jade just happened to be in this particular location. I guess. See, here's the difference between you and I, Arthur. I have been paying attention to the events.
I'm an alpha Homestuck gamer.
I really am not. I just have eyes that function and a brain that gives even the remotest amount of shit.
I missed everything to do with God Tears. Like, all the explanation about that was just... I never saw any of it. So, like, whenever
these...
Unfair,
but I have explained it multiple times.
No, you've given me, like, people die and if they don't die in a heroic way, they come back. And that's about all I know, but I'm like,
I have mentioned
just
deaths as well. I have mentioned just deaths as well. I know that because you were here for the fight between Vriska and Jack Noir, and that was what was kind of in the balance there.
Alright, yeah, fair enough.
Anyway.
I assumed it was just a synonym.
You can come out now. You're safe, I promise.
Jade?
Get your paws off me, you shit-fucking shit-fucker. Oh, fuck, shit, shit, shit-fuck. Fuck. You scurrilous fuck-shitting cat, unhand me so I may resurrect my accomplice at once. What do you want from me this time, you detestable poos, Rogering Charlton?
Hold on, do you, if you're a Durse, like a, if you're a purple god, does it have to be a Juster? And if you're a yellow one, it has to
no,
because
because Jade it can be either. Yeah, it can be either. Basically, it's either if you're doing something really good or doing something really bad, and you die.
So you just need to take a part in the story, I guess.
In essence, what the god tier death thing does is you. In terms of, like, story-related deaths, 99% of the time, if you die and it's in any way plot-relevant, you're going to be dead for good. If you fall down the fucking stairs, you're coming back.
Yeah, okay.
It's basically a way for an in-universe explanation as to why the only people who die are people who die in ways that are relevant to the plot.
Anyway, this next line is very ironic considering the voice of the character.
I do not want to buy any more of your potions. I already bought all the useless slop I could ever want from you and made a killing on redistribution. Your entrepreneurial tactics leave much to be desired. You are a deplorable businessman and an even shittier clown. Get off me. Did you just touch my boob? Don't touch my boob, you fuck-faced, dumb, buffing, toilet-guzzling idiot.
God, some words indeed. Where are they now?
Oh no! Oh no! Shit. Gamzee, what happened to you? You see what happened? Fucking ass. Just gonna keep manhandling John's evil mom and not tell me what Jay's doing under this house.
I did not sense you come. Where did you come from? I did not sense your approach.
You can't sense what ain't real.
It real. It seems you are quite real, Dirk.
That's because my buddy Jake just helped me become a whole hell of a lot less fake. You see, he believes in me.
Oh, no. Honestly, the conversation we're having right now there's a striking resemblance to the absolute nonsense. Never mind, it wasn't a comparison, it's just absolute nonsense as a general concept. Fair enough. Never mind, there's a striking resemblance to the general idea of absolute nonsense.
Just as I recall, with the lines.
Once your dream self appeared out of thin air, just as you have done now, and I did you a favour by helping you on your way. Don't you remember? There's no need to thank me, I'm quite benevolent by nature. I prefer to do the right thing, even in situations where I'm not likely to receive credit for my good deeds. Jesus
Holy
Christ,
shit.
Why did they... Wow, what a dickhead.
Holy shit, can you stop saying stuff?
No, need to be so rude. I'm just curious, and as an ancient scholar and learned scholar, I'm versed in a wide range of unusual phenomena. However, I must say I'm flummoxed by the nature of your being. What exactly are you?
I am Brain Ghost Dirk. You kissed my boyfriend. Prepare to die.
Shucky Dog!
Not helping, dude.
It's like that, that show, The Princess Bride.
Yeah, I was gonna say. I'm pretty sure that's the reference.
Terezi doing shit. Arthur, do you want to take Terezi?
Yep.
I'll remain as Gamzee. Mason, I'll also take Dave, because Dave is here.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah. Also... I'm going to be going soon, by the way.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Well, yeah. Terezi with the dropkick ambush from the fucking sky. Go, Terezi, kick his ass. Still don't have the slightest clue what's going on here, but I fully endorse this turn of events. Terezi, do you know what's going on here? You know what happened to Jade? Where the hell's Karkat? You okay? Terezi? Okay, she looks pretty serious about stabbing that clown. I can respect that. What about you? Hey, John's hot mom, did you see what happened? Shit, I mean, John's evil mom. Did you see what happened to... Okay, damn, that was a really embarrassing and inappropriate Freudian slip there. Don't think I'm gonna rebound from that one. I'm gonna stop talking now.
Did you really believe you could run from me forever, Makara? What made you think you could commit your crimes? That you could deceive me, debase me? make me feel like rancid circus trash. Only to slink away like a filthy cheese critter without ever having to pay the piper. Did you honestly think you would never face justice? What do you have to say for yourself? Answer me! Just as I thought, it is the response of a religious zealot sworn to a misguided vow of silence. Or is it the response of a coward? How I detest your horrid faith. How I loathe the soda sticky ground you kneel upon while you belch your vulgar hymns of mirth. How I revile your... Wait. It's her! She's here! What is she doing here? It was she who manipulated me into restoring my eyesight. Just as you were the one who instigated my spiral of self-loathing to begin with. Never would have considered her silvery-tongued offer in a million sweets if you not poisoned her. Oh yes, it's all too clear to me now. You and she are in cahoots, aren't you? Aren't you? Admit it, Makara. You have become just another lowly nibble of vermin scurrying after the seductive turn of her flute. You are both the worst kind of scum to me. Opposite and yet equivalent. It is the legislator's handbook. It is as the legislator's handbook says, that those who are cut from the same cloth are fit to swim from the same rope. Justice clear.
Stop.
Hacking her up.
Jesus.
Oh. Need to sour him like that. Right, I'll do this line and then I think I'm gonna go.
Alright.
This page and then it's
go for some nice moves. I particularly enjoyed how you took a casual swing at my arm in the middle of that combination, as if I'm not perfectly aware you understand the significance of the ring. I know you must have overheard my conversation with Roxy. Really, it was one of the great disadvantages of having a reputation for offering detailed explanation about your weaknesses. There are sure to be some eavesdroppers taking notes. But I really don't mind that you know my secret. What kind of sport would I be if I didn't give you a fair shot at defeating me? In fact, to show you what a generous and honourable opponent I am, I will give you one free chance at disarming me. I won't move an inch, I promise. Surely with your speed and swordsmanship, that will be a piece of cake. Well, go on, Dirk. Now that's it. Yeah! Fight me, you gutless poltroon! Alright, I'm done. Let's come with that.
Alright,
I'm just gonna end my recording and I'll send it over.
Right. I think we're gonna keep going to the end of this action sequence.
Yeah.
Okay.
But we'll catch him later.
Indeed. We'll see you around.
Yep.
See you. Anyway. I said fight back! What, now of all times you can't bring yourself to raise a hand to me? All you can do is grin like an imbecile. Ugh, stop smiling! I said wipe that grin off your face, or I will peel it off your skull! Take that, and that! Oh yes, clown, your reckoning is at hand! What do you think you're looking at? Dream on, miracle boy! Chief Deputy Pyrospine can do nothing for you now! No one can save you from your judgment!
Meanwhile...
Observing this tomfoolery for several minutes has been time well spent. I have no regrets whatsoever. On that authentic note, I shall resume my effort to resurrect my omnipotent daughter and regain the tactical advantage. As a being of cold, flawless reason and logic, I have no cause to anticipate further impediments to the simple objective.
Gee, I wonder if there's going to be any impediments to the simple objective.
Son of a dick.
Son of a dick. Oh, yeah, because of the Beckle influence in there. I said put her down. Bad anthropomorphic dogs. You're so bad. Oh my god, you're literally the worst pair of anthro dogs I ever saw. Drop that goddamn girl, I mean it. Don't you woof at me. Bad. Bad. You don't think I'm serious? I'm serious as a drive to the fucking vet. I'm not joking, you dumb mutts. I mean business here. See, I've got a sword too. It's sharp. And it's awesome. And it's fucking Welsh! Okay, listen. Jack and, taller white Jack. Clearly you're very loyal to Jade's corpse or whatever. But you aren't gonna help her by swiping her torso and growling at me like a pair of mangy assholes. Please, just put it down. Look, I got treats. I have snossages. Okay, I don't have snossages. I can get snossages. Okay, do you want to take Calliope? It's the papyrus voice. I will never give up.
Do you remember anything yet?
Not really.
That's a pity. I was hoping you might be able to tell me what my friends are up to.
I wish I could tell you, but I'm still drawing a blank on everything. I don't even remember what I was doing when I fell asleep.
Oh no.
Or even if I'm sleeping. But there is one thing I do remember. It's that gruesome image.
Maria!
Anyway. Are you supposed to tell if you're a ghost or not?
Ghosts have spooky blank eyes like me, but only after they remember they died. So until you recall what happened, I'm afraid neither of us will know.
Darn.
There is one way to be sure, I suppose.
What?
I could use some of my potent anti-sleeping magics on you to see if you wake up.
Anti-sleeping magics? I mean, magics?
Yes, but I must admit...
Okay?
I am reluctant to do so for selfish reasons. Ooh.
What reasons?
If you wake up, you will disappear and I will be alone again.
That's okay, I'm in no hurry to go yet. Or for that matter, to remember why I'm here.
No?
I can't put my finger on it, but I have this awful feeling something bad happened. Specifically, something that happened because of me.
Really?
Yeah. I'm worried I may have done some things I wouldn't be proud of. And that maybe I could have even hurt some people.
That is hard to believe.
I hope it's just my imagination. In any case, I feel like I could use some rest. And you seem very nice. So I'd rather relax here with you for a while than jump right back into whatever craziness is waiting for me out there.
Smiling face.
By the way, I didn't catch your name.
It is I, the Great Papyrus. I did not say it. Using my full name could bring us unwanted attention. Instead, you can refer to me. Huh?
Well done, you idiot. You just said your full name, the Great Papyrus.
Ah, but that is not my full name. Instead, you could refer to me by the name of my troll sona.
Your troll sona? What kind of name does it have? Something like Xander Shade, or like Masson Masson, or Julin Kirara, or something like that?
Nothing so tertiary and tangential. It's Callie. Pleased to meet you.
That sounds like a fun few characters. I'd like to watch a series about those characters.
I wonder if an episode of said series may have recently been uploaded.
On the Shade Boy channel.
Where you can find countless entertaining videos such as Reading Homestuck, Dicey Deeds, and even a Sonic Tier List.
And maybe even some classics like Diggin' Rinpa.
Yes, indeed.
That's the gruesome image I saw, by the way. It wasn't actually the one from Shadow the Hedgehog.
That's what killed Maria.
Watching Diggin' Rinpa killed Maria. The Maria I was talking about was Maria Maegi, a character from the hit series Diggin' Rinpa. I don't actually know anyone called Maria in real life.
I don't think I do either. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't think I do either. I broke character for a moment there, but nor do I.
The window appeared, and you're just in this conversation now. Anyway, it's nice to meet you too, Callie, after that brand endorsement that I get paid to do. Anyway, what is a troll sona?
It is the profile of a fictional troll which I enjoy pretending to be. See? Do you like her?
Oh, I get it. You're not really a troll?
Nope.
Oh my god, she's so cute. Or I should say, you're so cute.
Smile face, I think.
Anyway. What a good idea. Do you think I could make a troll sona too?
Yes. Oh yes, but you are not allowed to steal mine. It is my original character and you cannot steal. But that would be so lovely. Can I help?
Sure.
Which blood color would you choose?
The best color, obviously, which is green, duh.
That's the color of my blood, too.
Yes, it's also the color of Green-Eyed Shadow from the hit video... Garnthime, the Kojima-esque story of Sonic Destruction.
You might consider this to be a sellout, but shouting out your own content is not selling out.
It's just being a narcissistic dickhead.
Perfect for Shadow the Hedgehog.
Anyway. Wow, really? That's perfect. Our troll sonas will be like blood sisters or such. I don't really know enough about troll culture to use proper terminology. But let's just say that's what we are.
Agreed. Blood sisters it is.
Okay, what should my horns look like? Oh, and for that matter, should I have horns instead of my dog ears? Or in addition to them?
Definitely in addition! Your pointy ears are splendid!
Okay. Where would they go, though? Geez, I think we might need to do some drawings to make her look right.
Oh yes, let's!
Much like the drawings that Alex guy and also Rhea Hivestuck do for the hit video series Troll Sona miniseries in Homestuck halves of the Shade Boy channel.
You're very good at this.
Yes, I'm practicing for my brand deals that I'm definitely never actually gonna get.
By the way, this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends.
Fucking imagine.
Yes. There are over 500 unique champions.
No, don't go any further. Don't go any further. We're not actually giving them any free publicity. But anyway, yes, I'm practicing for all the brand deals that the Shade Boy channel is going to definitely never get because he says the fuck word too much.
As long as you don't say it in the first minute of the video, you should be fine.
That's fucking unfortunate. Anyway, Callie, is there there's something very familiar about you. Are you sure we've never met before?
I'm quite sure. I would have certainly remembered meeting you.
But you did know my name.
Well, yes, I knew of you.
I mean, fair, I am the ultimate life form, Shadow the Hedgehog. But anyway, I can't shake the feeling that we've spoken before. Maybe in an old dream I can't remember. I'm not sure if it's the sound of your voice or what. I don't recognize your face, but then that's not what you really look like, is it?
No.
Hmm.
Before you ask, my actual appearance is much less appealing, at least in my own view. I would rather you didn't see it if that's all right.
That's fine. It's not a big deal. If it's true that we've met before, I'm sure I'll remember in due time. Let's not worry about it for now.
Okay.
By the way, what's with this stage? Is it from one of your memories?
No, I thought it was your memory.
I don't think so. It would seem to be some sort of imaginary figment that turned into a real object. I wonder why it looks like a drawing.
Shrug.
Hey, why don't you come up here and help me get these curtains open? Since it's the only thing we've got in this boring vortex, we might as well try to have a little fun.
Yeah.
Meanwhile,
cut back to the action.
Snap back to reality.
No, you idiots. Oh, you idiots. You stupid, stupid adults. I am trying to revive her.
Whitney is not happy about that.
Nope.
Fine. If that is how you are going to be, you leave me with no alternative.
Oh. Trying to get the cat to fight the dogs.
I think it's more interested in the toy.
It's clearly not gonna fucking.
That was kind of a net zero.
Actually, no, it's a lot worse than a net zero. Because that's two angry dogs with swords and wings versus just a cat. And they're both drawing from the same power source. So that's basically a null type of, you know. Oh.
No, come back. You were supposed to drop her first. My calculation said you were supposed to drop her first.
Hey, John's hot mom.
Whoa, where is that music coming from?
What music?
Oh, for God's sake. Okay, I don't know why this happens, but I'm on the Geometry Dash Wiki, right? Because I wanted to check something. And for some reason, if I have a page open for like 2 hours, the sound will suddenly start playing on the ads that are like on the screen.
Oh, Fandom Wiki, you need to get that extension that just stops those from showing up in search results.
I'm sorry about that. That was a jump scare.
That is rough. That is rough that you're stuck on Fandom Wiki. That is unfortunate. Anyway.
I could just close the page, but whatever.
Just do.
Yeah, I'll just close the page.
Anyway, did you say you can revive Jade? Sorry, I got jump scared by Fandom Wiki.
Yes.
That's all I need to know. We're here. And whatever you do, don't die, okay? Cut to her dying, don't. Anyway.
Just metal pipe.
Hot mom.
Dave with the completely unintentional whiz.
God, there are a lot of characters.
Dave, what are you doing? Okay, that was a cutaway. Anyway, I'll take Carcat then. Kanaya, wait up! You know I can't compete with your drinker fastness!
What was Kanaya's voice? Is that the Irish, the Scottish one?
Scottish, Irish. Irish is Solix, other guy.
Yeah, yeah.
More to the point, a guy. Oh, God damn it. God, we're missing everything. How much bullshit is it that we're pretty much the only two assholes left who can't fly?
It really is such bullshit.
Dragon Ball flying. Dave, what the fuck? Can't talk. Chasing dogs. Okay, fucking, what was... Fucking... Did we have anyone...
Dirk! Fucking... How long did you want our standoff to last? Don't get me wrong. I'm flattered you seem to enjoy my company so much, but you are missing a golden opportunity to sever my arm while I'm preoccupied with overconfident blather. Really, you would be doing me a favor by taking my arm. It would bring me that much closer to following in the footsteps of my true self. She was a very successful pirate, you know. She lost her arm in battle to a cunning adversary she underestimated, much like yourself. Won't you help me become who I was always meant to be?
God damn it, you fucking kinshifted. Anyway, shut up. I'm not going to cut off your arm. It's such an obvious trap. You'll just put me to sleep or something with your psychic powers, or maybe a long story. I have a better idea.
Ow?
If I can't get the ring off your finger...
You take the finger off? Oh.
I'll rip the soul out of your body.
Fucking Doctor Strange.
He is a prince of... He is a destroyer of souls, so...
Jesus.
Yeah. Which is... To be honest, I... don't even want to hear anymore. Next time you have an update on what my ancestor has been up to, please just keep it to yourself. Do you want to take fucking Friska or Mina?
What voice was Mina?
Fucking Power from Chainsaw Man.
Well, I don't know what that is, so.
Shit, take I'll just Friska, do Friska. It's Columbo. Anyway. You sure?
It's embarrassing. I cringe every time I think about her self-indulgent exploits.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't she realize this sort of thing never works? You don't just go and insert yourself into the middle of all the action in the most ham-fisted way possible just because you can't stand another second being out of the spotlight. That always goes horribly for everyone. Even worse, it ends up making you look like an idiot. And even more worse, it's making me look like an idiot by association. Why couldn't she have thought this through a little more? Why couldn't she have at least told us first?
Shrugging my shoulders, yo.
How is it that I understand this and she doesn't? She's how much older than me? Like a bajillion dream bubble sweeps or something. All that experience and wisdom, and she's out there floundering around like the fucking noob.
Floundering.
It's so disheartening. She wants to be like Marquise so much, just like I used to, but she's nothing like her. You kind of need to have a fuck ton of experience doing, you know, a lot of ruthless piratey shit before you can pull that off. You can't just be a bookish dweeb all your life, then suddenly decide to flip the badass switch and expect people to take you seriously. Also, to truly pull that off, it might help to actually be a goddamn adult. I know, I must be totally off my sway chair for suggesting it, but maybe, just maybe, there are certain roles and behaviors which are best left to fully developed grown-ass people. Not to sound like a wet blanket, but my ancestor's journal contains some extremely mature content. So now we have yet another stupid kid trying to fill the boots of a legendary pirate queen, and it's amateur hour all over again. All I can see in her is me when I used to... And it makes me want to... Ah!
Stop moving around all angry, you're fucking me up here.
Sorry, I'm just dismayed by some of the implications of her actions. Is this really how I came off when I used to pull this sort of shit?
I dunno, wasn't there.
I have a sickening feeling it was just like this. No wonder nobody can stand me, and here I am bitching at my ancestor like I know better, like I've evolved beyond all that, but... Have I really?
Do I go around thinking I'm smarter than I used to be, but end up repeating all the same old patterns without realizing it? Was the plan to find this treasure and build an army just a restatement of my immature, egomaniacal bullshit disguised as a more strategically sensible plan? If I can apparently keep kidding myself about this crap forever, then how would I know the difference? I guess the thing I hate most about her stunt isn't that it's a dumb plan or that we weren't included, it's that it's making me wonder if I can trust any of my own judgments, even after all this time.
That's some baller inward reflection, Sirk.
I don't know about that. If it's so baller, why is it making me feel like shit?
That's what it's supposed to do, I think. But, like, temporarily?
I guess. What about you? Does any of this resonate at all? I know you used to stir up shit with your friends. You must have done some outrageous things which you thought were necessary for the good of the team. When you look back, do you ever wonder what you were thinking or if you ever truly evolved?
Nah.
Oh, come on. Don't leave me hanging in self-doubt limbo here. Give me something, please. Oh, Pakes's?
Pisces, whatever.
Pisces.
I don't know, maybe. See, my thing is, I don't verbally torture my cray schemes like all the circuit girls. That works okay for me. Because I made some mistakes, but who really gives a flip?
You don't care if you make mistakes?
Not like you and she do. Irania's deal is, what she's doing now isn't much different from how she always did stuff. Stuff she does is never about the thing she's actually doing. It's about what those things mean and making sure everyone knows what they mean. And above all, making sure everybody understands how important she is, because she's obviously the source of all that critical meaning without which all action would be pointless, right? But that's not how I rolled. I just did shit. And the shit I did meant only the things that shit accomplished. And if that shit accomplished a dumb thing, that sucked. Then I guess that's what you call a mistake, and no fucking well. Mistakes ain't make me feel too bad, since I don't really connect results with my self-worth. You feel me?
Yes! That is so right on. If you asked me a long time ago, I'm sure I would have insisted that's exactly how I felt about everything I did too. But I don't know if that's true anymore. In fact, I'm sure that wasn't true. I was always invested as hell in the consequences of everything I did and how it made me look and how it made me feel about myself especially.
Okay, I'll admit, I always felt hella bad about decisions leaving me with less gold. Well, damn, I feel like a tide of shame wash over me just thinking about going broke.
Well, of course, who the fuck wants to be poor? That's for losers.
Word.
Rude.
Hey, fuck you. Hey, fuck you, you two. Fuck off. Anyway.
Get a job, loser. Anyway, I have no idea what to do now. Her ill-advised power play has ruined everything. I can say that because I have a job.
Well, while that green boy fucking sobs in the back of that window over there, well, we still have this treasure here. Why don't we just do this shit without her? We could whip up another ghost army. March it straight to English and start beating them down?
I don't think so.
Why not?
If you want to know the truth, when we were manipulating all those ghosts, Irania was doing most of the work. Her abilities are a lot more advanced than mine, I guess because she's been around for so long. I was kind of riding her coattails, making it seem like it was a true collaboration between us. It was actually very nice of her to allow people to get that impression. She didn't have to. I should have just told everybody that. I guess I wanted to believe it too, like we were equal partners in crime, ancestor and descendant, united at last and working great together. Hope you don't think that makes me a huge phony.
I'm gonna give a fish about that.
Yeah, you're right, you wouldn't. I shouldn't be saying needy shit like that. I'm just a bit depressed because it feels like I'm running out of friends all over again.
I hear you. She ditched me too. Can't blame her, I guess. What can I say? Girl loves her pirate Sona. You wanna be that pirate chick so bad? You might have fallen ambition. She cast her lure into the lake of, cute but dumbass dreams. I think her mind fang ideal is ridiculous to be.
Oh, hang on a sec, my doorbell's ringing.
I'll just keep going here. Ah, that journal man. Tales from the Pirate, he won't shut up. Then I'm not one to talk about hero worship. I think my adult self happens to be the best, greatest, most perfect one beautiful woman ever. And if you ask me if I want to crack at a job, I'd be like, club yes, put me down for that. But I legit hope it works out for her. But yeah, I don't mean I didn't get ditched. That's just... makes me sad. And we'll just cut ahead to when Mason gets back.
Sorry about that. It was a package.
We're at same. Top of the screen.
Same.
You sure we can't salvage the plan without her?
I don't know. Possibly. The way I was picturing it, a major feature of the original three-pronged approach was to use the army to lead a first-wave assault against him. Then while he was preoccupied by all those ghosts swamping him, I would go in for the kill with a secret weapon. So without an army, I guess we'd need to get close enough to him to use it before he killed us.
Like, sneak up on him?
I guess. But I get the feeling Lord English is not the kind of guy you can just sneak up on.
Okay, what if I found some way to teleport over to him, and I beat the shit out of him with my wrestling moves, then you bust out the weapon?
That would be awesome if somewhat implausible. I guess we can think it over, but if we're getting real here, this has all made me feel pretty lukewarm on the plan. Arania checking the fuck out and me recoiling at her hubris, which is obviously just my own bullshit getting thrown back in my face. It's a bit much. You have to be able to trust your own judgment to make good plans, right? I don't know if I do anymore. I certainly don't right now. Remember when our crew started rebelling against me in that cave and I was kind of lashing out? I think I might have been forcing it a little, like that whole dramatic speech I gave when I jumped into the flaming pit. Was that really a genuine thing or like a desperate last attempt to be who I think I should be?
That was pretty badass, though. I mean, yeah, you were chewing the scenery and being hammy as fuck, but I thought it was cool and kind of funny.
It wasn't supposed to be funny, though.
Oh.
Oh, man, I really don't know what to do. I'm too depressed to think proactively about any of this. Maybe the truth is, I don't even care all that much if anyone stops Lord English. I think all I really cared about was getting to do it myself.
Yeah, that's a good enough reason if you ask me. But, hey, if you ain't feeling it, you ain't feeling it.
What if we just gave up on the mission?
Gave up?
Yeah, what do you think?
Sure.
Sure? You don't think that would be a wussy move?
Well, yeah, it would be. A couple of cowards did it. But that ain't us, so we cool to do whatever.
That's a very good point.
Nothing wrong with sticking a fork in a shit idea that just made you miserable. Hell, the best choice I ever made involved giving up. One day I said, fuck the throne, ran off to the moon. That's how this whole crazy mess kicked off. If I didn't do that, I wouldn't have met you.
Smile face. Meanwhile.
Meanwhile.
Jake, your hope field is dissipating. Come on, man. You don't need to rely on her to keep believing. Try and hold your shit together for just a little longer.
Fiddle faddle. Fiddle faddle.
God damn it, Jake!
Mr. Strider. What are you doing to this troll, if I might ask?
Get her the fuck out of here!
Surprise picture.
Gotcha.
Why won't you fight back? Why won't you say something?
Oh, so everything's kind of failing now.
Yeah. My power is failing.
Why won't you die?
Forgive me, Jake.
Oh no.
Oh no.
And now.
Oh my stars, oh, my and daughters. That. Jeez.
You want to take a Rania again?
Whatever. Good grief, that was painful.
Yeah.
Terezi. Whoa. Please stop. You motherfucking hurting me.
Oh. Oh, God. What have I done?
Sleep! Loud snore.
I'm sorry. What kind of expression is this?
It's like, oh yeah, you're sorry.
Ah! Oh!
Honk. Clown Watch in 302. Oh, zombie.
The fucking z-
Because it's a thriller. Sleep tackle.
This fucking action sequence is ending in the dumbest way possible. Pow!
Cartoon sound effects. Kapow! Oh no! Oh,
and the glitch is back.
The motherfucking glitch.
You know why they call me the motherfucking glitch?
Bang! They're abstracting.
My eyes!
Where's our boy? Where's our boy who's gonna fix all this?
Where be John? Well, there's Jake just watching all this bullshit go down.
Is Jake about to fix everything?
Who knows? Well, clearly not that!
Oh, God!
Gamzee! Stop
that!
Yeah, fuck it. Us both fucking doing that at the same time works with the glitch. Fuck it. I'll take Rose from here.
Okay.
Oh wait, is this some kind of Black Rob thing? I certainly hope not. Ugh, think, Lalonde, think. What does Kanaya tell you about this quadrant? Does it really involve such gruesome fisticuffs? I can't remember. Oh, I was probably drunk during that particular lesson. What am I saying? I was drunk for all the lessons. Oh, what a disgrace. I'm the actual worst auspices who ever lived. The actual worst. He put her in the fucking pile driver. Tombstone pile driver.
Clown suplex. Flip. Yay. Whee.
Atomic double juggalo backbreaker.
Holy shit.
Put her in the tombstone pile driver.
This place shall become your grave.
Terezi. No.
Kal-El, no. Oh, God.
What the fuck's even happening here? What the fuck?
Ayo, what the fuck?
Ayo, what the fuck? fuck! Okay, Gamzee's caught her.
Pardon me, Sir Jester. I don't know what this masked bandit has done to deserve such a throttling. Something sufficiently felonious, I presume, but is it hard to imagine she has not been punished enough and then some? Perhaps you could, if it's not much bother, see to unhanding the lady? Maybe? What, you're gonna drop her in the lava?
Poor choice of words, man. Enough! I don't care if this is some sort of grisly courtship ritual. This has to stop!
Spell. Wingardium Leviosa. Yank. Should I flip him off?
Oh, he is flipping him off. Oh, hell no! Let her go this instant, you heinous card-packing shit mime! We aren't gonna hug it out this time, bro. I'll tell you that much right fucking now! What the...
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. The Condus has arrived. And apparently she's really cold from the teeth chattering, if you see that shit.
Yeah.
She's just like...
It's fucking cold here.
Yeah, it's fucking cold in the vacuum of space. I've been dramatically standing on the edge of my ship for the last 10 minutes. It's fucking cold.
Jeez.
And I guess that's the end. Oh, well, into act six, act three, I suppose. Did we just seriously do all of act six intermission two and act three in and now act three soon? In the span of two episodes?
I guess.
God damn, we're good. We're good. Hell yeah. Welcome back. Again. Your unimpatience has been appreciated. I can only assume that waiting for the next installment of my vaunted series, Homo Suck, was as time-consuming for you as it was for me. I have been working my ass off, like one of your human motherfuckers. At perfecting my craftsmanship. You are probably wondering if the fruits of my laborious toil were extremely successful. I believe you will find the answer to be the following word. Yes! I have done it. Where the fine arts are concerned, I have reached the pinnacle of Achievement Mountain. I stab my cane into the peak like a flag, thus making a snowy avalanche on the haters below. Jealous much, fat ass? How did I do such a sensational feat, you ask?
Manga.
The mystery to success lay hidden amidst the Byzantine mangas all along. These occult wizardries of the brush, purloined from cool scrolls of wise men from the earthling past, east and past, both, have been gathered for my studious perusal inside a seductive tome, emblazoned with a frivolous tart. However, mastering each sly gambit of the trade is no easy task, and yet easily mastering them with great difficulty, is exactly what I did. This fact is called a game changer. To professionals in the business, that is. Previously, before I literally transformed into the supreme doujinshi mangaka, standing before your very eyes,
I made some predictable plans regarding what goes next in my story. Got everything ready? Drew all of the trolls. Look, all of your favorites are here. Grab, grab. Hog friend. Cape douche. Smelly horseman. Other guy. Bullhorn wimp. And lest we forget a sultry array of miscellaneous bitches.
I do love the term miscellaneous bitches.
If used in a gender-neutral fashion,
yes,
very
indeed.
Funny.
Indeed, correct.
If used in a gender-neutral fashion, very funny. If used in a gender-specific fashion, maybe reconsider.
Yeah.
Just maybe reconsider.
Correct.
Oh, also, the before trolls, in case of emergency. Bro, he didn't even apply the invert adjustment layer correctly. God damn. such as, in case I was in need of more fictitious idiots to murder inside my drawings. But these portraits are now a moot point.
Trash.
All of this wretched trash goes in the place where it belongs, which is to say, the garbage. That's what happens when you're an artist. Sometimes you change your idea plans because they suddenly seem terrible due to your astronomical strides in creative mastery. These were the pixel puppets of a laughable amateur. They are beneath me now, much like you are. But in spite of all your bad shortcomings, I will let you observe my artistic breakthroughs because of how proud of them I am. And watching people be impressed in my drawings, even dumb jerks, makes me feel great about myself and my accomplishments. Behold, my exclusive private gallery.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Abraca-fucking-dabra, you nasty shit nerds! Read it and weep. And tell me how good you think it all is. Thanks. Okay, that's enough admiration. Back to our story.
Copyright, do not steal.
Look who just swaggered into your fucking business! It's God's gift to the Yowies! My research tells me. Get a load of those baby reds.
Is this a boy kissing episode?
I really hope not. I really hope not. I don't want it to be a boy kissing episode in the hands of Caliborn. It's going to be very homophobic if it is.
Yeah.
Anyway, you may recollect that this blushing Bishonen dreamboat...
What the fuck?
This is
our alpha male! Not that I blame you for not recognizing him from his once previously odious visage of before. But now, by my skillful hand, this gorgeous male hero has been allowed to radiate with the supreme divinity of Boymonger Heaven. Oh my, what have we here? Oh no, it is, isn't it?
So just a giant at symbol in the background?
Oh god, no, it is, isn't it?
See,
that's
yeah.
A copyright C, but copyright. Oh god, Mason, I am deeply afraid that you may be right.
Don't look now, but another bashful Bishy approaches the stage. Every cell in my body is attempting to go in different directions. If I could will myself to disintegrate right now, 18. I would be doing so. Just simply scatter to the winds, never to be reassembled. It's our troll male! Crab guy! Quite a temper, this one. He bellows himself hoarse daily. At our smart talking. Give no fuck, alpha male. Becoming less and less coherent by the moment.
Yeah. What is he even saying?
I'm having a drink here. I'm just gonna take.
I'm gonna have a drink as well, just on your behalf.
A for the voice, and B so that I can mentally prepare myself to read these next few words.
They are quite some words.
These Moe bros put the pal in palpable chemistry. The kind of which is bad, as well as erotic. The sage elders of Manga describe the quadrant they occupy as, I quote,
yep.
Sundere. It is a tempestuous liaison of mutual grievance. And yet, deep down, they know in each other's heart that they are solid dudes. Hmm. Okay, I know what you're thinking.
Step off.
This is wrong. What's going on here? The touching, the tenderness. I know it, you know it. Let's not play a game with each other. Where, perchance, are the bitches, I can hear you ask. You raise an excellent point. But hear me out. Okay, bros. Hear me out on this one.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. No, Mason, no. You were right. No, we're going to...
Oh, no, why?
It's the homophobic boys kissing episode. No.
It's the oxymoron.
No.
The mangas play by different rules. You'll agree with this when you hear the facts of my rationale. Naturally, such maudlin displays of touching and simpering have no place where only cocksure masculine gentlemen are present.
Caliborn, I feel like you really have to tell us something here. I feel like you have something to inform the class of here.
Yeah.
However, by the mangaka's illustrationary, he changes everything. Where before our males were coarse, chiseled, and crudely angular, built for prime time like a fucking garbage truck. Plowing through the wall of an industrial beef mill, so cut, so maxed out that they could only provoke inside a young man thoughts of raw power, never debauchery. Until now, that is, because of manga and its inherent capability to transform all that is hard and cruel into figures of sublime beauty. I find this artifice to be much like the siren spell of the trickster, yet impossibly even more haunting in its allure. I must say, the artistic ploy is ingenious.
What did you think I would do in this moment?
Oh my god. Oh, this is... The homophobic boys kissing episode.
It's a shame that Arthur had to go.
Yeah, if he hadn't, I'd have been tagging out like 3 pages ago.
Yeah.
It opens up so many possibilities to the fiend of indecent smut, where before it was all but impossible to render truly sentimental imagery without resorting to babes and bimbos galore. Due to the utterly unacceptable happenstance wherein macro guys are physically poignant with each other. To which reasonable men, is the most unwelcome persuasion of lechery. Or that is, it was. Until now, again, Caliborn.
Yeah.
You have something you want to share with the class. Look how smart this hoax is. Thanks to manga. See, through the elegance of beauty and finesse, it softens the uncouth male exterior. Beveling the angles of pure muscle, taming his incredible angriness, and by the flushing of cheeks, the doing of brow, the glistening of eyes, one brings out of any brute his true inner bishi. Every time I have to read one of these words, I can feel one of my organs beginning to fail.
Yeah.
As my body actively chooses to try and kill itself so that I no longer have to read it.
Yeah.
Which actually is manganese for a beautiful fucking dude. If you're confused, basically the idea is you pretend them to look more like girls to make it less weird for everybody when they decide to touch each other. I mean, it is repulsive to witness, do not get me wrong. But yet it remains magical in its forbiddenality.
Hard work by Caliborn.
Motherfuckers.
God, those fucking fingers.
The fingers clipping into the fucking back rooms here. Oh? But what's this?
Protected by law.
An amorous female sashays into the sexual picture to spoil the boy fun. It's none other than What's-Her-Face. How is every page worse than the last on this? Like at least it makes sense here. At least in this, we can in-universe say Caliborn did this. I don't have to, it's not like before where the only recourse is to go, Andrew Hussey's a piece of shit. You know, at least here, I can at least rest in the knowledge that I have an in-universe person to blame for this.
Yeah.
And it feels a little less horrendous.
Yeah.
In post. In the moment, it feels exactly as bad.
Yes.
It's mostly because I know that Caliborn sections are short. And so I know that the finite end point of this severe mental torture is not far.
Yeah, I would certainly hope it isn't.
Don't be deceived by the fact that this feline floozy is too unimportant for me to bother naming. This is an original character who shall not be stolen. Please respect my property. This saccharine trait has some interests, which include... Excuse me for one second. Anyway. Which include giggling, making me puke, using cat words instead of normal words, serving no purpose, wearing stupid clothes, probably smelling horrible, getting murdered in drawings.
The thing is, he's not entirely wrong.
Hey, come on. I'm not going to let you disrespect a fellow artist like this. Come on. It's,
nah.
Let's leave Nepeta out of this, okay?
Oh, no, I was just talking in general, like...
It's like, of all of the characters in Homestuck, what? All of them just...
No, I mean, in general, to do with cat girls in anime. Yeah. I mean, remember the Sonic OVA?
Oh god, look, Sarah was one thing, alright? I feel like to a certain extent, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm fighting this battle on the side of cat girls here. They're not just Sarah. Sarah was a bad idea in conception. Leave these things separate.
Oh god.
Can someone say owned? Moving on. Well, what have we here? Oh, for God's sake.
You belong in your professional.
Hello, boys, this plucky strumpet seems to say with her eyes. She is looking to horn the fuck in. on our two top dogs' illegal passion paradise. She is no doubt hoping for muchas smooches, fat chance sister, idiot girl number whatever likes. Total. every second is agony. Total failure. Getting friend-zoned by quality male honchos. Living in perpetual disgrace. Being a complete fucking third wheel to some cool boys. Not being worth the alpha male's time of day. Not being worth the crab crab's time of day. Not being worth anything, aka worthless. Bye! Here comes another prime OC of mine, feel hot off the press. Alright, who do you think it's gonna be this time, eh?
I don't know.
Who do we think it's gonna be this time, eh? It's Friska, of course it's Friska. Why wouldn't it be Friska? God fucking damn it, kill me. Not too shabby, right? You can... I'm out of water is the problem, and this voice hurts. But I shall bear this suffering for the sake of no one else having to deal with this. You can just call this lucky tell this lucky lady is brimming with chutzpah. Methinks she will be a very controversial character with excessive complications and ambiguous moral stuff. In her personality bullet points, her traits, and other such character things will be a lot to list, which is fine, because it will help you believe my creation is more interesting. In fact, this is one such advantage of dominating all known manga as I have done. When you're this good and brilliant, you don't even really need to tell stories anymore. You can just make some characters and list their various qualities extensively. That's good enough. The many, many intriguing personal facts of this truculent female provocateur shall be listed extensively as follows.
Oh, God.
She actually thought she was going to be relevant. Keep dreaming, bitch. It think we've wasted enough time on these nobodies.
Another time.
Don't you? Let's drop the bullshit and stop fucking around. You're probably wondering, who is responsible for all this mayhem, you ask? Uh-oh, here he comes.
Hold the fucking phone.
Don't look now, but it's none other than the big man himself. Damn.
Just Sam.
Oh, God. Oh, and who, you ask, is this brooding, beautiful dude? This is yours truly, my self-insertion guy, which is my prerogative to do as an artist. I learnt this from my master, the wise-ass ghost who haunted my computer. He was the best there was at stuff like this, he told me once. Truly, he was quite the piece of shit. Seriously, can I get a goddamn...
Holy smokes. Like the fucking cane.
The fucking... Ask any decorated scholar to the School of Manga, and he will say... Before you stands the...
Too many vowels in a row.
No.
And also the fact that it's a word that you have to say.
I was about to say, Mason, I really hope that you said the comment about the vowels because you are joyous enough to have not known the pain of late 2000s anime fandom.
Yeah, what was happening in... What else was happening in the late 2000s?
Financial crisis.
I don't even know what I... The new Super Mario Bros. Wii, I guess. That probably took up more of my time.
pain and suffering in the Middle East. Damn, we really haven't changed, have we?
No.
Before you, you know, fuck it. No, no, I can't keep doing the voice. I will lit. I made the joke about my feeling my organs die. I can't. I have to resort to normal voice.
Understandable.
Before you stands the yowiest motherfucker who ever lived. All things about this gorgeous bastard tell you loud and clear, this is a man of style and class. He is dressed to kill, literally, haha, yes. Look at this fancy Dan, strutting his stuff and dapper as fuck. Your boy here peacocks hard at honeys aplenty. Oh no.
What if peacock was spelled no, peacock? No. Oh, that's not a good word.
No, it's not that. It's fucking pickup artist culture. Oh my god. I am going to actually throw something into the sea. I'm going to war with Poseidon for this. It's not necessarily his fault, but I just need something that will kill me very fast. Negging the bitches and closing the hose in a coat that is fit for a lord. Look at that goddamn coat. I don't know how he gets that coat, probably due to a shenanigan that takes place later. I doubt it matters that much. It looks great though, and I love it. Also, how about a hat?
Oh no.
No.
Is this ahead of its time?
No, it's exactly during its time. This is fucking 2014, baby.
God. This was... Super Smash Bros. For 3DS and Wii U was coming out at this time. Couldn't he now... just be excited about that?
We are now... Pat, do you really want Caliborn to be a Nintendo fan?
I mean Andrew Hussey. Maybe he could have just given up on Homestuck and just played Smash Bros.
No, oh, God, no. What? Oh... But yeah, we are now past to the point of Homestuck being over a decade in the past for the page we're reading. In fact, we're well past that point. Holy shit,
we have been for a while.
Holy shit, I've just realized we're nearly within 1,000 pages to go, and it's only been like, what, a couple months since we hit 2,000 pages to go? Tops. God damn, we're going to be done with this damn series by December.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Well, it's not. Hang on. Anyway, sure, why not? The hat is not canonical to my fanon, but I do not see the harm in such a dignified accessory. Ah, yes, perfect. Who could ever be accused of being an asshole while wearing that? Nobody. Oh, also, sick nasty green electricity wings. Fucking check. I think we are good to go here. Big man, holler at your woman. Every blood vessel in my body is closing.
Yeah, he seems like a nice guy. Oh, here we go.
John, come on, kick his ass, punch him in the head. Please. Anyway, his woman, that elaborate tram from the surface of the tome, hustles to the side of her debonair hotshot. My lady, he doffs rationally. The man brims with intellectual ideas she wouldn't understand. He knows many things about the world and being strong, but yet, he still doesn't know who she is. A goddess of Marga, perhaps? It is no matter. She must bow down before her lord, as must you all someday. Goddess of Manga, bow down. John, please, please punt him in the head. Please drop kick his ass. Please, please, John, come in with the steel chair.
Come in with the gun.
Just shoot him in the head. Just shoot him in the fucking head.
I'm going to shoot you with my gun.
She bows before you submissively and in a subservient manner. Everything is correct about this situation. You think she's really attractive, and it makes you feel weird physically. And yet, unlike your sister, she knows her place. I don't like your comparison there.
Yeah, no, Calibon, that is not. Calibon, no, no.
Run that shit back. Please, I'm begging you. I mean, and has no opinions or words to remark about. I mean, not to imply that any other aspect of her is like your sister, like being attractive. Wow, what? Read into stuff much? Oh, you decide. You have too much time on your hands. You stop thinking about this topic starting as of immediately. As well, all is well.
I like how even Caliborn was conscious enough to realize the implications of what he just said.
Without you blurting out unnecessary sexy scandals, it is almost a bit too ideal, you think? Something is amiss.
Question mark. Hey.
You go in for a closer look at the eyes of the handsome boy's appearance and notice a worrisome discrepancy. No, this is all wrong, you frown. Those glassy red peepers, lovely though they are not your lord's final form. Oh no. His eyes are supposed to flicker about.
Da-da-da-da.
With the hat flavors of my loyal frog puppet guys, legend demands. This is a trait of supreme invincibility, owed to a full body union with the clockwork the clockwork bullshit. I don't know why that's supposed to happen yet, but maybe we'll find out together.
Hey, asshole, I'm talking to you. Here we go.
Come on, John, please. Please, another intense
turn. Another intense turn. He just looks concerned. It's you, isn't it? You're the guy who wrote that horrible story with all the fake Daves. You're behind all this, aren't you? I don't know how I know that, but I can just feel it. You're the one who Vriska and her pirate pals are all trying to stop. It was you who put all this into motion in some way I don't really understand, which means you're responsible for like a trillion people dying and universes blowing up and all my friends getting scattered around and acting like idiots and my dad being dead. Okay, maybe you're not totally responsible for us acting like idiots. Most of that is on us. But all that other bad stuff is your fault somehow, isn't it? I'm gonna kick your ass!
I'll start the voice again. I think I've rested enough. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a hater! As you can see, the former ghost of the male hero has come back to haunt me. This is not his first unwelcome intrusion into my private important affairs.
Who are you talking to?
Technically, it will not be his last either. But it will mark the first time he is forced to pay a toll-faced crude teleportation crime. Oh yes, today he will pay with his teeth and with his blood. Game over, kid!
Right. An animation thing. Oh, okay. Go down a little bit.
Ooh.
Yo. What a way to end the episode, this one, man.
Yeah.
Oh shit, he's like real dead.
Oof.
He can't get resurrected now.
Oh yeah.
No god tier, no dream self. Oh.
Oh shit.
And Jake's dead.
God, it's all happening. Oh god.
Jane's dead. Swap him back. Okay.
Egbert kick.
I love how he is actually fully just killing his ass, beating the shit out of him.
Oh god. This is sad.
Cutting back and forth.
Jesus.
Motherfucker got freezered.
Yeah.
The fact that Dave is even remotely, like, for a moment holding off holding off. Yeah, no!
God.
The fact that Dave held those two off for even a fucking moment is impressive, to be fair.
But not a moment enough.
Heroic death. Not god tier. Silly bean.
He just looks unimpressed.
God damn, and a heroic and a just death there. The fuck is she even doing?
She's just fucking through the planet!
I'm sorry, yeah, she's... Yeah, because she's mind-controlling a bunch of fucking... She's just fucking throwing planets around because she's just, like, mind-controlling all of the fucking... Yeah, Damaras.
And the Condis just started doing the fucking Future Trunks hands.
Oh my god.
Oh no.
Okay, Terezi's probably fucking dead.
God. Oh god.
Rose is definitely probably fucking dead.
Oof.
God. Okay. Yup, Roxy's back.
Oh, Roxy.
Saved him. Okay.
Saved him, yeah. Hopefully.
Terezi is somehow still fucking alive.
The fedora.
Oh no, the hat. John's just fucking... Ooh. Actually nearly started beating this man to fucking death.
Yeah, he's shook.
God. Okay, this is certainly an eventful way to end an episode.
Yeah, Jesus.
Already in progress. I'll just go to the next page and fucking okay. Well, I guess that's where we'll end this episode of Reading Homestuck. What the fuck happened?
That was just a lot.
I'm just okay. Let me just fucking note down here, fucking in the reminders tab for fucking next time Arthur anyone other than us two is on. Fucking who's dead? Colon. Okay. Kanaya. Kanaya, vaporized. Carcat, fell in lava. Jake. Jane, Dave. Jade, we saw die, but I'll put her down as well.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna put Aradia because there's no fucking way she's getting out of this one.
Phew.
There's no fucking way. She is not surviving that. She is literally got by the throat by the fucking Condors. In fact, I think it might actually be quicker to list who's still alive. We got John, Rose, Roxy, Terezi.
I think that's it.
Yep. Yep. God damn. What page number is this? Okay, 6902.
Nice.
Nice. I wonder what happens on page 6969.
Well, thankfully the Caliban stuff is done, so there hopefully shouldn't be any boy kissing.
Yeah. I guess we'll see next time.
Yeah, jeez.
Well, oh yeah, no, sorry, Dirk is alive still.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Still alive. He's miles away, but he's still alive.
Yeah.
And now that's it.
Okay, woof.
Whew. So, Mason, what did you think of this fucking massacre of an episode of Reading
Well,
Homestuck?
Yeah, it was a bit of a
and
bloodbath, wasn't it?
One.
Jeez.
Yeah, these fucking multicolored bloodbath out here.
I remember it was a while ago that I said it felt like things were really coming to a head, but I think this is about as head as we can get.
Yeah, we've come to the head.
We've had existential head, and now we've got actual the head.
No, we don't actually have head, Mason.
Well, thank goodness. We very nearly did.
That would disrupt...
Am I wrong?
Yes! Yes, you are!
I think if John didn't show up, he very well might have.
Oh, I'm lightheaded. I'm legitimately lightheaded. What the fuck?
Yeah, I need food.
Whew. So, yeah, any other thoughts on all this?
Besides the parts that obviously weren't supposed to look good, everything looks amazing, especially in that final cutscene.
The animation there was fucking...
Yeah.
That shit was quality, but fucking okay.
Yeah, indeed.
Okay. Whew. Okay, minor sit rep on myself. My voice box hurts from all the Caliban. I'm lightheaded. And I'm still suffering the after effects of severe early 2010s cringe.
Yeah.
Whew. So if you guys like these episodes... Last one and this one. This one's going up on a Thursday because fucking... Oh my god.
Yeah, we can't wait to get this one to you.
Oh, yeah. And we've got something funny planned.
Well, that that was my kind of cover-up reason.
Yeah, whatever. I won't say what the funny thing is.
Oh, of course not.
But we've got something funny planned because next...
Yeah, should be
next
good.
Next episode after the one you're currently watching is on April Fool's, so... So if you like this video, hit the like button. If you very much liked it and want to see more this video and want to see more like it, hit that subscribe button. We upload episodes of Reading Homestuck every Monday or Tuesday, depending on your time zone, and we upload other things on Thursdays or Fridays, again, depending on your time zone. Other things, like the Troll Sona video that we did last week.
Yeah.
I'm quite happy with how it came out. Very, very pleased with it. And soon, another episode of Dicey Deeds. We have a recording date planned out for it. You should be seeing it sort of early to mid-April. And it is it will be us playing Honey Heist. I don't know yet if it's going to be a one-parter or a two-parter, because, again, we haven't recorded it yet. But I'll tell you, you'll know at the time. You'll know at the time. Honey Heist, we will be playing as bears, and we will be stealing honey. Mmm, honey. honey. it's probably just going to be me, June, and Arthur for that. But speaking of me, June, and Arthur, I'm so good at segues. You can follow me on Tumblr, where I post things such as the Troll Sonus stuff, and it's usually reblogs other than that, but yeah, you can find the Troll Sonus stuff there. Some fun times. Along with the fan art made by Rhea Hivestuck. It's so good. Put the one of Xander absolutely. On the screen. Put the one of Xander on the screen, editor me. If you haven't already passed the fuck out. but put the Xander one on the screen. you can also follow June on Tumblr and on Instagram. She posts things there sometimes. I would be passing over to her to talk about it, but obviously she's not here. I figured you'd have gathered that by this point. I would hope you'd have gathered by this point. And you can also follow Arthur on Twitch. He streams sometimes. Schedule as of right now to be decided, but you can see some stuff from him on there. And Mason, do you have anything to say before we sign out?
No, I think but that episode was fantastic. Follow everybody else's stuff. I don't have anything that you can follow, so use that energy, if you have any left after this episode.
After this fucking debacle.
To follow people's things and leave us a comment and say something nice, I guess. That'd be appreciated.
Or don't say something nice if you don't have a nice thing to say. I don't give a shit. Well, it's engagement.
I mean, you know, don't force it.
it's engagement. If you want to say some rude ass shit, I'll leave it. Who gives a shit? It's engagement. But, you know, leave a comment, do whatever. Like, comment, subscribe, YouTuber bullshit. And we'll see you in the next video.
Yes, we will.
Later.
Later.